So, what is symmetry? We often use the word symmetry in our everyday life. Therefore, we have some intuitive picture about what is symmetric and what isn't. But how do we define symmetry with rigor, especially when there are so many ways to realize it? Well, there are three major fields that define symmetry to meet their needs: art, mathematics, and physics. Although the concepts are somewhat connected, let's focus on physics. Basically, we call any transformation a symmetry that leaves the system invariant, meaning that when we apply the transformation, all variations and additional terms drop out of the equation of motion, which describes the dynamics of the system. This is equivalent to saying that the Lagrangian is altered by at most a total derivative. So, on the fundamental level, when computing the action as an integral over the Lagrangian, the action remains unchanged. This is because the integral over the total derivative is the same as the function evaluated at the boundaries, which in this case must yield zero. There are still different kinds of symmetries. First of all, we distinguish global versus local symmetries. Demanding symmetries to be valid locally leads to the concept of gauge theories. It says that the transformation depends on the point in space. So, in other words, the transformation is a function of x. Global symmetries, on the other hand, are the basis of formulating a theory in terms of the Lagrangian. Knowing which particles to describe and which symmetries to fulfill is enough to write down the complete non-interacting theory. And secondly, there are continuous and discrete symmetries. The difference is easily seen when rotating a perfect circle compared to rotating a square. In nature, there seem to be three very fundamental discrete symmetries: charge conjugation, parity, and time reversal. The somewhat surprising news is that the universe only looks the same after applying all three transformations according to the CPT theorem. For a good example of a CP violation, watch the video we did on kaon decay. When it comes to continuous symmetries, they may be the least obvious kind of symmetries because they are too self-evident. Just like the angle in the rotation of a circle, we have to determine a continuous parameter that leaves the equation of motion invariant. Global continuous symmetries have far-reaching impact on a physical system. As Emmy Noether proved 100 years ago, every differentiable transformation that changes the Lagrangian merely by a total derivative results in a conserved current. In the low energy regime that we live in, we observe 10 continuous symmetries, which are connected to the 10 generators of the Poincaré group. This includes Lorentz transformations as well as translation in space-time. So we are looking for 10 conservation laws now. In the following mini-series, we will explain different conservation laws based on Noether's theorem. That's pretty much it for an introduction on symmetries. See you next time!